stop burning money. I put it to say, figure out within yourself where does the issue lie, right? And fix it. Are you overspending, you know, impulse spending? Find ways to address those issues and find ways to mitigate those issues, right? Use cash instead of credit cards. Most people are just, you know, addicted to shopping every single time. And the way the world is going, they make it so easy to shop where people with one-click shopping, a bunch of boxes come from Amazon at your door, right? You can disable one-click shopping. Find ways to minimize impulse spending. The last two are key to me because I have the right insurance in place. One thing is, if you don't have the right insurance in place, if you have an issue, right, it could be one accident away from going back into debt. So have the right insurance in place because then you can shield yourself from all those unforeseen issues. The last one, have an emergency fund. Because most times when people have emergency funds, when something happens, let's say, for example, driving your car, right, and the engine knocks, they go right back into debt, put it on a credit card, and or just go bubble more money to get into more debt. So having the right insurance is a good shield for those unforeseen issues coming up. And the last one, have an emergency fund. It's a good cushion to say, hey, if I lose my job or something happens, I can always go back to that account. I know for me, when I had the issue over a decade ago, right, there was no emergency fund. So when I didn't have a job, when there was no income, I was just spending my credit card like crazy. That was how I was able to maintain myself back then. So, but having an emergency fund is a good way to say, hey, if something happens, there's a pile of money somewhere I can go back and dig to before I get a new income or something coming up, you know. So that's first thing, stop borrowing money. The next one, you can minimize the interest paid. Like I said a while ago, right? So the cost of debt is the interest you pay over the life of the loan. So one way is for it to refinance, for example, your student loans, right? If you can get a lower interest rate, then that would minimize the interest paid over time and also help you get out of debt much faster. The next one, use a credit union. So actually, I had a client a few months ago. She had a car loan and interest was crazy. So what we did for my coaching session was, hey, let's go to credit union, borrow how much you owe on that car at a lower interest rate. Pay off the car loan. Now you now owe the credit union, but at a much lower interest rate. So that's an option to say, hey, instead of paying this huge interest rate on a car or something, right? Go to a credit union, get a much lower interest rate, pay off the car loan. Then you can now pay back the credit union, which now has like a lower interest rate, and you should be able to pay them off much faster. The last one, do not consolidate your student loans or your loans, right? Because when that's done, you're combining all your loans into one big loan. And that's not the best plan for you. One, you might have high interest rate. Also, because it's such a big amount, you lose motivation as well to pay off that loan. So I would recommend do not consolidate your loans at all. Just we'll show you if a good process to go through to pay off your loans. So, but I would say don't consolidate. The next one, budgets. This is, to me, this has been a game changer for my personal finance life.